I thought of talking about this concept of the metrics that we use in the software as a service and business model. So last week, if you remember, Swap took us through the software as a service, the model, the domain, you know, what are the key features of such kind of a business model, and also he gave an overview of the metrics, right? So what I thought of covering today was, we'll talk a little bit in detail about some of the metrics and how do we actually calculate those metrics. Okay, so the first metric, or you know, the most important metric that we are going to cover, is something called as the MRR, or the monthly recurring revenue. Okay, so what is MRR? So you see the first point here, given a customer base, MRR is the expected or the predictable revenue that a company can earn from that customer base in a given month. Okay, this MRR concept is used widely in subscription-based business models. So SaaS is one example, or telecom is one more example. So you have a lot of subscribers who pay, or you purchase prepaid packs, right? 1 month pack, 2 months pack, or something like that. So in all these cases, you can use the MRR. You can calculate the monthly recurring revenue. So this MRR is a key indicator of whether the company is acquiring new customers. So basically, if you're acquiring new customers every month, then the growth rate, MRR growth rate, is a proxy which tells you by how much you're growing your business every month. All right, and it is also used to make financial projections. So every month, if this is the recurring revenue that we would get every month, then what would be the revenue that we will get at the end of the year? So you can make that kind of projections using this metric. This is the basic formula for calculating the MRR, which is the average revenue per user into the total number of monthly users. Okay, but so though this is the basic formula, what makes the calculation complicated is it is calculated at the company level, the plan level, or the customer cohort level. And every month we need to consider three categories of customers: existing customers, the new customers acquired, and the customers churned. Okay, so this is these points that you see on the screen here are sort of a primer for the MRR concept. Now let me get into the calculation part. Okay, we'll start with a very simple example. Okay, very simple example. So just assume that for the current month, telecom company has 10 subscribers. Okay, now each subscriber has subscribed to a different prepaid plan or a pack, okay, for that month, and he has paid the corresponding amount. Okay, so let's say you have users 1 to 10, and each of the user has subscribed to a particular plan amount. Okay, so this is all the subscriptions have assume that all these plans are valid for the month of February 21. Okay, so the total monthly recurring revenue for this particular month of February 2021 is nothing but the sum of all the individual revenues generated by each individual user. Okay, so this 2882 that you see here is nothing but the sum of the individual revenues that you get for each and every user for the month of February 2021. Okay, this is MRR at its simplest form. Okay, now let me get into a more complicated form, or a more realistic form, for the MRR calculation. Okay, so what makes it more realistic is every month the company will acquire new customers, and some of the existing customers might churn. Okay, so churn as in they might leave the company, they might unsubscribe from the service, that sort of thing. Okay, so assume that each subscriber has subscribed to a different prepaid plan or a pack, and he has paid the corresponding amount for that month. Okay, now typically this data will look something like the plan amount that he might have paid, right? Like what we saw in the previous sheet. So you might have this kind of a data, and from that data you calculate this metric called as the ARPU, or the average revenue per user. Okay, so that's what we said, right? A couple of pages back we talked about the formula for the monthly recurring revenue, which is nothing but the monthly average revenue per user multiplied by the total number of users in that month. Okay, now from this data for a given month, from the subscription data, you can calculate the average revenue per user. Okay, now so that takes care of the first metric in this formula. Now how about the second metric, the total number of users in a particular month? So let's see here, let's say you have months from January to December. Okay, just assume that I'm starting the business in January. All right, Now, in the month of January, when I am starting my business, let's say I acquired some 46 new customers. Okay. Now, since that is the first month in which I am starting my business, there are only customer acquisitions. There is no customer churn. Okay. So churned users I am putting as zero. Okay. And here, if you see, I am calculating something called as the net users or the monthly active users or the MAU for short. Okay. So this is nothing but the new users acquired minus the churned users. So for example, you have acquired 46 new customers in the month of January. No customers have churned in that month, since that is the month you have started the business. So the monthly active users or the net users for the month of January is nothing but 46 minus 0. Okay. Now if you see the next month, at the end of the first month you had 46 customers. Okay. Now at the beginning of the second month you have acquired 38 customers, and during the month of February 15 customers have churned. All right. So the monthly active users at the end of February is nothing but this 46 plus 38 minus 15. Okay, so 46 plus 38 is nothing but 84. Subtract 15 from that, you get 69. Okay, so this is the monthly active users for the month of February. Similarly for March, if you see, it is nothing but it is 69 plus 40 minus the churned users for the month of March. You already had 69 users at the beginning of March or at the end of February, and you acquired 40 new users during the month of March, and 9 users left the service during the month of March. So 69 plus 40, the 109 minus the 9 will give you the net users or the monthly active users for the month of March. Okay. And again, this monthly active users is something that they use in an e-commerce scenario as well. So you take any e-commerce company, if you ask them how many customers do they have, they won't say I have 1 crore customers or 2 crore customers. Okay. The number that they will give is nothing but the number of customers who are transacting on that e-commerce platform during a particular month. Okay. So that's what we call as a monthly active users. Users who have actively subscribed to that service for a given month. So that is a metric that we calculate for each month from January to December. Okay. So now since we have the number of active users or the net users for each month, and here we have the average revenue per user, let's say it is 100 rupees. I'm just taking an arbitrary value here, but ideally this would come from this kind of data. You will take that average, you will put that here, and then you just multiply the number of users, the net users, multiplied by the average revenue per user will give you the monthly recurring revenue for each month. Okay. Any questions, guys, here until now? How to calculate the MRR? Or any questions on how do we arrive at this net users or the monthly active users?
No, none from my side. It's clear.
All right. Okay. So let's look at the next metric. The other important metric that you use in your SaaS model is the MRR growth rate. Okay. I was just saying the next metric that we will look at is called as the MRR growth rate, and the MRR growth rate is a proxy for by how much your company is growing or by how much your customer base is growing each month. Okay. And a positive MRR is good. Positive MRR growth rate is good. The higher the growth rate, the better. Okay. Now, how do we calculate the MRR growth rate? You can look at the formula over here. So it is nothing but the current month MRR minus the previous month MRR over the or divided by the previous month MRR. Let's multiply that by 100 to get a percentage value. So that is, if you see here, since we have started the business in January, there is no point in growth rate over that. So if you see for the next month onwards, it is nothing but, if you see it for February, it is 6900 minus 4600 by 4600. It is your typical percentage growth formula. So that is how you calculate the MRR growth rate. Okay. And the other important metric that you have in your MRR is called as the MRR churn rate. Okay. So this MRR churn rate, if you see the formula here, it's nothing but the churn MRR minus the expansion MRR divided by the MRR at the beginning of the month. OK, Okay, again, you multiply that by 100 to get a percentage value. Okay, so that is how you get the MRR churn rate. So here, if you see, we have two additional metrics that we need to calculate. So one is the churn MRR and the other is the expansion MRR. Churn MRR is nothing but the revenue that you have lost in a particular month due to the customers who have churned in that month. Okay, and expansion MRR is nothing but the additional MRR that you get in a particular month due to new customers you have acquired during that month. Okay, so if you see the expansion MRR calculation here, it is nothing but a multiplication of the new users for a given month into the average revenue per user. So you have acquired 38 users in the month of February, and you are just multiplying this value 38 by the average revenue per user, and you are getting the expansion MRR as 3800. Now what about the churn MRR? Again, it's similar. For each month, you take the number of churned users or the number of users who have unsubscribed from the service during that month. So for the month of February, 15 users have left the service. So 15 multiplied by 100, which is the average revenue per user, gives you the churn MRR for February. Okay. So now that we have the expansion MRR and the churn MRR for February, you calculate the MRR churn rate as follows. Okay. So this is nothing but you can just see from the formula here, the churn MRR minus the expansion MRR divided by the MRR at the beginning of the particular month. Beginning of the month is nothing but the MRR at the end of the previous month. So the MRR at the end of the previous month is 4600. Okay, so that is what goes into the denominator over here in this formula. And the numerator is nothing but the churn minus the expansion MRR, which is nothing but the 1500 minus the 3800. Okay, now a negative MRR churn rate indicates that you are acquiring new customers. Positive MRR churn rate indicates that more customers are leaving your service than the number of customers who are additionally joining your service. Okay, so that is how you calculate the MRR churn rate. MRR growth rate should be positive. Ideally, MRR growth rate should be positive. MRR churn rate should be negative. Okay, so these are indicators that you are growing your SaaS business. Okay, any questions here until now before we go move on to the next concept, next formula?
No, sir, you can proceed.
All right, thank you. Okay, so MRR, the metric that we just discussed is the recurring amount that the company earns every month. Okay, so month on month, you say, okay, so January I learned this. So now I have a customer base. Each customer has subscribed to a particular plan. So all the entire customer base on average gives me this kind of a revenue. So that is how you calculate the MRR for every month, where you say this is the recurring amount that I get every month. So that's why you call it as a monthly recurring revenue. Okay, and there will also be other fixed one-time payments that will be made to the company by its customers. So for example, the entire topic that I'm talking about, right, it's based on a project that Akhil and I are working on right now. And they have one more metric called as the total contract value. Now again, TCV is one of the other important metrics in SaaS. And in this current scenario, which Akhil and I are working on, they calculate the TCV as a sum of three components. Okay. So basically they sell a particular product and they install the product in the customer premises, and they earn a subscription from that product, monthly subscription from that product. Okay. So for each project that they do or each contract that they draw with the customer, they calculate something called as a total contract value, which is nothing but the sum of the sales amount plus the installation amount plus the recurring amount. So the total contract value is nothing but the sum of the fixed as well as the variable payments that the company gets, okay, from a given contract or a project. Okay, so TCV is another important metric when it comes to a SaaS business. Apart from that, we have two other metrics. So one is what we call as the annual recurring revenue, and the other is called as the annual contract value. Okay, now I'll tell you what is the difference between these two metrics, the ARR and the ACV. Okay, so consider this scenario. Okay, so there are three customers. So customer A agrees to pay, let's say, $1,000 per year. Okay, and he draws up a 1-year agreement. Okay, and there is one more customer, customer B, who pays, let's say, who agrees to pay $750 per year, and he draws up an agreement for 2 years. Okay, he each year he pays $750. Okay, and customer C draws up an agreement. It's a 3 year agreement. For each year he'll pay $500. Okay, now just so this should be a dollar actually. My bad. So the So for all the three customers, let's say the company has only these three customers, A, B, and C. Okay. So the if I am calculating the metrics for all the three customers, I will be calculating these two metrics at the annual level. One is the annual recurring revenue or the ARR, and the other is the annual contract value or the ACV. Okay. So how do I calculate the ARR? It is nothing but it is the sum of the 1,000 plus 750 plus 500. Okay. So the per year amount that each customer pays, I'm just summing up those three, those individual values for each customers. That is how we get the annual recurring revenue or the ARR. Okay. But this is different from this metric called as the annual contract value, which is more of an average measure or a normalized measure. Okay. What do I mean by that? See here, this annual contract value I'm calculating for each year individually. Okay. So year one, year two, and year three. Okay. So for year one, just see how I'm calculating it. So it is nothing but the $1,000 that will be paid by the first customer, the $750 that will be paid by the second customer, and the $500 that will be paid by the third customer. Okay. So in the first year, I will get the individual amounts from each of the three customers. Okay. And since I have three customers, basically I'm just summing up the values paid by each individual customers, I'm just dividing it by three. Okay, so the 1,000 plus 750 plus 500 by three, which is nothing but the 750, is my annual contract value for the first year. Okay, so which is nothing but, you know, it's an average value that I get per contract, per customer contract, at the end of year one. Okay, for the second year, if you see, the formula is a little bit different. It is 750 plus 500 by 2, which is nothing but this 750 paid by customer B plus the 500 paid by customer C divided by 2. Because here, if you see, the customer A has drawn up just a 1 year agreement. He will not be with us for the second or the third years. Okay. So for the second year, we will not consider customer A's amount. We will consider only the fee paid by customers B and C. So the average fee paid that year, or the average contract value paid that year by these two customers, the active customers in the year two, is nothing but the 750 plus 500 divided by two, which is the 625 that you see here. That is for the second year. For the third year, again, you see, both the customers A and B won't be there, because customer A, the contract has ended at the end of the first year. Customer B, the contract has ended at the end of the second year. And during the third year, we will have only one customer, that is customer C, who will be paying us $500. So the annual contract value that we get at the end of year three is nothing but the $500. So that is the difference between the annual recurring revenue and the annual contract value. Okay, where the annual contract value is nothing but an average measure of the average contract amount that you get per user during a given year. Any questions, guys? All right. So that is what I had for today. An overview of MRR. Simple MRR calculation scenario, just to make you understand. And more realistic scenario where we'll have new users and churned users every month. So we'll calculate the average revenue per users. We'll calculate the active users. And then we'll calculate the MRR. Then we had the growth rate and the churn rate, and at a year level, if you look at the bigger picture, so we have the metrics such as the total contract value, the annual recurring revenue, and the annual contract value. Okay, so yeah, this is what I had for today.